لبيك يا حسين لبيك يا حسين لبيك يا حسين يا مولانا. So we find at the time of Imam Hussein, the people of Kufa wrote thousands of letters telling him to come to Kufa, saying that they will back him and saying that they will give bay'ah to him. But when it came time to act on what they promised, a lot of them went against it. And this left Imam Hussein in a very difficult position. We can apply this a lesson in our day-to-day lives. When we promise to do something, when we promise to give a certain quality product, or promise to give something in a certain time period, we need to make sure that we deliver that in time, or we deliver the same quality that we've promised.
أجسادا من شباب يا الله هل تنبت الدماء في أرض كربلاء عزا وكبريا ما أعلاه سبحان صبره.
The other thing that I remember when we say لبيك يا حسين is that Imam Hussein عليه السلام, he stopped a whole war just to pray namaz on time. So we need to make sure that we implement that in our day-to-day lives. If Imam Hussein alayhi salam can stop a whole war, then what's a meeting? What is serving a client? Nowadays, a lot of people do understand that it is prayer time and that we should pray on time. So we should take that into consideration. Labbayka ya Hussein.
يا مولانا لبيك يا حسين لبيك يا حسين لبيك يا حسين.